We all struggle with the problem of doubts. At some point in life, many of us at times have questions about our faith. We have doubts about the God we serve, doubts about the Bible. While it is not a behavior Christians should continue to practice all the time, we need to understand doubts is part of the human condition. The Bible had many great men and women who had their moments of doubts. In Genesis 18, verse 10 through 15, you find Sarah had doubts about being able to give birth because she thought she was too old. And in Luke 1, verse 11 through 18, Zechariah had doubt what the angel Gabriel came to tell him, that he's going to be able to have a son. He did not believe that. In verse 18, Zechariah asked the angel, "How can I be sure of this? I am an old man, and my wife is well along in years." You find in Judges 6, verse 33 to 40, you find Gideon had doubts. He twice asked God for a sign. In the book of Job, Job doubted in God's goodness when he lost all his livestock, all his servants, his children, and finally his health. And in John 20, verse 24 to 28, Thomas would not believe that the Lord was resurrected unless he could see and touch Jesus himself. He had his own doubts. The Bible tells us in verse 24, one of the 12 disciples, Thomas, nicknamed the twin, was not with the others when Jesus came. They told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he replied, "I won't believe it unless I see the nails wound in his hands, put my fingers into them, and place my hand into the wound in his side." 8 days later, the disciples were together again, and this time Thomas was with them. The doors were locked, but suddenly, as before, Jesus was standing among them. "Peace be with you," he said. Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and look at my hands. Put your finger into the wounds in my side. Do not be faithless any longer. Believe." Thomas said, "My Lord and my God." So today, if you are wrestling with doubts and disbelief, turn to God and ask Him to help build your faith and have a stronger foundation in Him. The Bible tells us in James 4 verse 3, "When you ask, you do not receive, because you ask with the wrong motives, that you may spend what you get on your pleasures." One major thing that kills faith in every Christian is doubts. James 1 verse 6 through 8, the Bible tells us, "When you ask, you must believe and not doubt, because the one who doubts is like a wave of the sea, blown and tossed by the wind. That person should not expect to receive anything from the Lord. Such a person is double-minded and unstable in all they do." Hebrews 11 verse 6, the Bible says, "And without faith it is impossible to please God, because anyone who comes to Him must believe that He exists and that He rewards those who earnestly seek Him." If you know any Christians that has doubts, the Bible tells us to have mercy on those who doubt. It is easy for us to judge, condemn, and look down on doubters. Understand that no one is immune to doubt. It can and it does happen to all of us at times. But today I'm here to let you know, if you are seeking for a way to minimize all your doubts, do you need a breakthrough or desperately looking to be free from the spirit of doubt, there is no better place to turn than God's Word. If it is in the Bible, then it is God's promises to you. Just follow His instruction. You will live a more abundant life. Meditate on these promises from the Bible when you have doubts. Let's begin. Mark 11, verse 22 to 23. "Have faith in God. Truly I say to you, whoever said to this mountain, 'Be taken up and cast into the sea,' and does not doubt in his heart, but believe that what he says is going to happen, it will be granted him." Mark 11, verse 24. "Therefore I say to you, all things for which you pray and ask, believe that you have received them, and it will be granted to you." Luke 12, verse 29 to 31. "And do not seek what you will eat or what you will drink, and do not keep worrying, for all these things the nations of the world eagerly seek. But your Father knows that you need these things. But seek His kingdom, and these things will be added to you." Romans 4, verse 20 to 21. "Yet with respect to the promises of God, he did not waver in unbelief, but grew strong in faith, giving glory to God, and being fully assured that what God had promised, he was able to also perform. When you lie down, you will not be afraid. When you lie down, your sleep will be sweet." Isaiah 59, verse 1. "Behold, The Lord's hand is not so short that he cannot save, nor is his ear so dull that he cannot hear. 1 Thessalonians 5 verse 24. Faithful is he who calls you, and he also will bring it to pass. Romans 10 verse 17. So faith comes from hearing, and hearing by the word of Christ. Isaiah 55 verse 10. For as the rain and the snow come down from heaven, and do not return there without watering the earth and making it bear and sprout, and furnishing seed to the sower and bread to the eater. Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not be in want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He restores my soul. He guides me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. Surely goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Psalm 34 verse 15. The eyes of the Lord are on the righteous, and his ears are attentive to the cry. Matthew 7 verse 7-8. Ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and the door will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives. He who seeks finds. And to him who knocks, the door will be opened. Matthew 7 verse 9-11. Which of you, if his son asks for bread, will give him a stone? Or if he asks for a fish, will give him a snake? If you then, though you are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your Father in heaven give good gifts to those who ask him? Philippians 4 verse 13. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. 1 Thessalonians 5 verse 24. Faithful is he who calls you, and he also bring it to pass. 2 Timothy 1 verse 7. For God did not give us a spirit of fear, but a spirit of power, of love, and of self-discipline. James 5 verse 16. The effective prayer of a righteous man can accomplish much. Amen.